Question 6. Use simple linear regression model to predict sales for time period 1 to time period 20. Calculate MAD, MAP, and MSE. First of all, let's use regression function in Excel to find B0, B1 for our simple linear regression model. B0 is nothing but the intercept of this linear regression line, and B1 is nothing but the slope. Alright, first of all, let's go to Data Analysis under the Data tab. Let's go look for regression. Click OK. And Y range, nothing but units sold. X range, nothing but time period. Alright, let's save the output on this Excel spreadsheet. Let's see where we can put it. Okay, why don't we put it over here? Click OK. You see, right away, the Excel has generated a bunch of information for us based on this simple linear regression model. But the one we need is right here, intercept 23.375 and slope, which is 1.279. Okay. In Excel, there are many other ways of getting B0 and B1 for our simple linear regression model, but this one is the most useful and popular one, so I'm going to stick with that one. All right, now we have B0, the intercept, and B1, the slope. Now we're ready to make the forecast. First forecast is nothing but the intercept B0, absolute cell reference, plus B1, absolute cell reference, times X1. X1 is nothing but time period 1. Alright. And similarly, let's make those forecasts integer because we are talking about SUV sales. Forecast error would be actual sales minus forecast. Absolute deviation is the absolute value of forecast error. APE is the absolute value of forecast error divided by the actual sales. Forecast error squared is, well, forecast error squared. So let's do that for the remaining 15 time periods. All right. If you want to make those numbers look nicer, for example, we can use the old trick, format cells. Numbers, let's say we want to, okay, let's be generous, let's keep 4 decimal places. That'll be good enough. Okay. All right. But we're not done yet. We also want to make predictions for time period 17 all the way to time period 20. And it's very easy using the same formula and drag it down. So the predicted sales for time period 17 would be 45 SUVs, and predicted sales for time period 20 would be 49 SUVs. Alright, time to calculate MAD, which is the average of all the ADs. MAPE is the average of all the APEs times 100. In the end, MSE is the average of all the squared forecast errors. And you may wonder, do we need to use solver again over here? The answer is no, because this is how linear regression model is set up. actually to find B0, B1 over here, we are actually minimizing MSE. So that's why we don't have to use solver anymore to solve the problem for us.